I had a huge celebration that was planned for tonight, but in the end, I didn't need it. I didn't need the balloons, I didn't need the streamers, I didn't need the pyro, because I found something that summed up the worldwide reaction to me winning the WWE Championship. I found something that summed up the feeling of the WWE Universe. First, there was shock.
Yeah.
Boo-hoo. Then there was anger. They say pictures are worth 1,000 words, but those two images are worth 1,000,000 celebrations. That little girl will forever be known as the Miz Girl, and I want to thank her. I want to thank her for reminding me of the struggle I had to go through to get here. Reminding me of everyone that ever said anything about me that I wouldn't make it. All the people at MTV that said I would never be a WWE superstar. Then when I got here, all the WWE fans and every superstar in that locker room said I would never amount to nothing. To the JBLs, John Bradshaw Layfield. To the Triple H's, to the John Cena's, I say this. The Miz is WWE Champion! Randy Orton is simply the first in a long list of people that I'm going to demoralize, because when I say I'm going to do something, I accomplish it. And mark my words, I will be the longest reigning WWE champion in history. If anyone ever says you can't do something, if anyone ever says you can't live your dream, believe them, because you can't. It takes an exceptional person to prove everyone wrong, and I did just that. I am nothing like any of you or any of you watching at home. I am nothing like you people. You people live your lives without ever accomplishing any of your dreams. But I'm one in a billion. Because I actually have achieved my dreams. And the list goes on and on of so-called Hall of Famers, so-called legends that never won the WWE Championship.
Miz,
Mr. Perfect.
Miz. As a person whose name is on that list, let me just say this. Congratulations are in order. You're the new WWE champion. But let's face it. You beat a guy that had already been attacked by 7 other people before you won the title. Now, that may make you clever. That may make you an opportunist. But in my book, and I think everybody's book here, that doesn't make you awesome.
Really? See, that sounds like ramblings of a bitter old man who fought for 4 decades and never did what I did in one night.
Oh, boy. King, will you stop, please? Will you please stop? Come on. Just stop.
Everybody stop?
I mean, it's bad enough that you've been out here downplaying the Miz's victory all night. I mean, you even at one point called it a fluke. So this is Miz's night. It's his celebration. So can you just come down, sit back down, relax, and let him have his moment?
You're right. I'll do that. But you know what, Miz? If you're the champion that you say you are, you would call somebody out here that hasn't already been beat down by seven guys and give them a title shot.
King, you gotta stop. If you don't stop, Miz may end up making an example out of you. You may be that guy.
Hey, Miz, do you hear what Cole just said? You know what? Some people that are on that list of names that you were talking about that never became WWE champion are on that list because they never had a championship opportunity. And to be honest with you, I've been here since 1993 and I've never had a WWE title match. So, you know what? If you're the champion that you say you are, Miz, what about giving me a title shot right here tonight?
Yeah, that's a great idea, Jerry. But I'm not interested in defending my title tonight.
Well, Miz, I think you just verified exactly what I was saying. You may be a champion, but you're not awesome. You're a coward.
How dare you? You are a shell of a Hall of Famer. Oh.
Can I have your attention, please? I have just received an email from our general manager. And I quote, "Congratulations, Miz. What you did last week was impressive. But that was last week. And this is tonight. So while you may not be interested in defending the WWE title, I am. Therefore, I'm making our main event, The Miz versus WWE Hall of Famer Jerry the King Lawler for the WWE Championship tonight. But wait, there's more. In 3 weeks, there's a pay-per-view known as TLC, Tables, Ladders, and Chairs. And I can't think of a better way to kick off the countdown to the pay-per-view than by making our main event tonight not just a championship match, but a Tables, Ladders, and Chairs match. Ooh.